Welcome to the Fray Dogg Gaming Channel. I am your host, the Fray Dogg, and here we are with the last of three walkthroughs for the division's main base of operation wing unlocks, if you will. And this is the tech wing, and we need to go save or rescue Paul Rhodes. This mission will unlock the tech wing and your base of operations and will allow you access to that skill tree. So if you haven't watched the other two videos, we've already gone through the med wing and the security wing, and you're probably sick of hearing it, but I will recommend that you do the security wing first, and then it doesn't really matter whether you do the tech or the med next. The med is easier because it's literally right outside the base of operations. The tech is one of the more challenging missions to run solo. If you did watch the security wing, you know I died quite a bit at the end of that, but that was just some sloppy gameplay on my part. So the challenging part about the tech wing mission, if you're running solo, is that you will be up against the cleaners, and they like to use flamethrowers, so it can get really, really dicey. So on our way to the mission, we get sucked into this little side mission. We'll take these guys down and get some XP for it, and do this. And we got sucked into one when we were doing the security wing. Actually, I think we did two little side missions on our way to the security wing. So here we go. We'll climb up on this shipping container and get the higher ground angle at these guys, take them out. These little missions, I mean, that they can, if you're, you know, by yourself, they're fine. You know, if you're running around with a couple other people, you know, it's not a waste of time, but I think your time's better spent just running to the main story missions and jumping in those when you can, when you're with a group. Now, if you're just going off and planning on going into matchmaking when you get to the story mission, that's fine too. But when I'm playing with my friends, I prefer to just do the story missions whenever possible. You know, these things are nice, but they do take up time. And you know, if you're an adult and you have things like a family and a job, you know, to schedule some time to get online and play with your friends, you don't want to be just running around grabbing whatever loot you can by chopping up some of these bozos and saving hostages. It is fun at first to learn, you know, the control schemes and experiment with new weapons, but you know, by and large, if you're playing with a group, you're going to want to stick to the story missions as much as possible, because that's going to yield you the most XP and the most loot. So, all right, did we get sucked into another one? All right, oh, just got to clean out the last of these clowns. So there's a couple right here. Yep, right in this doorway. Let's all hang out in the doorway and get shot together. Oh, dummies. There we go. Take him down. Good deal. Alright. Grab the gear and let's go, bud. There we go. Let's get to the subway morgue. Yeah, look at that ragdoll. It's floating around. Here we go. Alright. Right to it. So hopefully we don't have any more of these little encounters. Oh god. Of course. Had to say it. I think that we can avoid that one. I guess not. Guys, I'm running out. A little sloppy gunplay. Take this guy down. I like this little converted SMGs, man. They can do some damage. So I think we avoided the rest of that nonsense. So now we'll go down into the subway. Try and get Mr. Rhodes out of here so that we can open up our tech wing. So here we go. There you can see our friends the cleaners. It is a lot of fun to pop the tanks that they're carrying around on their back. When I'm playing with multiple people, I will try and because I'll typically be running some sort of sniper rifle. I will try and pop those things because they will explode and they will take out other baddies around them when they do explode. Plus, it's fun to just see those guys running around flailing their arms about before they get blown to smithereens. So here we go. We're gonna come down and try and take these guys out systematically. And there we go, we got him. I think there's still a couple more guys. Yep, there he is, poke your head out, pal. So I'll tune him up a little bit, try and get him down. Oh yeah, we took his tank out. So here we go, run around down here. Yeah, be careful of those explosive containers because that works both ways. You know, they can get you just as much as you can get them. I've noticed that they don't typically target the containers. So we popped another tank. Here he goes. Boom. Nice. They don't, the enemies don't typically, you know, target the containers, but, you know, they're not the best shots in the world. So if you're close to one, they might pop it, not on purpose, but, you know, you still get taken out and get caught on fire, and then you have to run around and try and put it out. So we'll just run around. I know there's I think there's another crate behind here that we can grab. No, we're just gonna check our weaponry here, see if it's an upgrade and see if it's worth swapping out. Yeah, it looks like it might be. So I try to do this, you know, in quiet spots through the mission. You know, especially after I pick up a bunch of stuff, you know, go through, see if it's worth upgrading, you know, whether it's, you know, a weapon or some armor. You know, it can help tremendously. So here we go. Nothing really interesting there. So I do tend to deconstruct items as I play, just because, you know, your inventory space is valuable. And I like to keep a lot of inventory slots open. So here we go. We're back to it now. I think there's gonna have some company coming up from here. Yep, there we go. Got a guy with a riot shield. They're kind of a pain, but you can take them down pretty easily. So that's that. Run in here. I don't think there's a resupply crate around here. I don't think so. So we're just gonna head downstairs. Got some more guys that we gotta take out. I think they're coming up from the other side. So, try and stay in cover as much as possible when I'm playing solo. When I'm playing with friends too, but, you know, especially playing solo going into an area that you haven't gone into before, I like to play conservative and stay in cover because you just don't know where people are gonna come from. You don't necessarily know what the angles are yet of the map, but once you play through some of these missions a couple times, because you know it is fun to go back and play to the next difficulty level up, the hard difficulty level, you know, as a challenge. So and once you understand like where the choke points are and where the angles are, you know, you can get a little more aggressive. But if you're playing solo, I still recommend to play conservative. You know, it's typically how I play, unless I'm playing real sloppy. But so we got a couple more guys we gotta take down. Yeah, here we go. Oh yeah, there are those flamethrowers. They'll do a number on you, so you gotta be careful and keep those guys at bay. You know, these guys aren't too bad. As this mission goes a little further and at the end, you know, their flamethrowers get a little more distance, they're smarter about it, and there's more of them. We just had a couple guys right here, so it wasn't too bad. So I think there's a restock crate over here and maybe another crate in this back room. Yeah, so you can see him on your mini-map. Yeah, there's a little backpack, so we'll open that up, see what we can get. Don't know what it is, but here's a restock, so we'll grab that. Head down to the next area. Keep going. So this is a pretty big map. A lot of these maps are really big. You know, some of them there's not a whole lot going on, but it's still neat. I mean, it just the scale of this game, the scale of the map is huge. You know, it's similar to, you know, if you took all the planets from Destiny and threw them into one big map, you know, that's kind of what you're looking at. The scale of it's really, really enormous. So let's keep it going here. We're gonna head on down through the like a little broken out piece of the train track or whatever the hell we're in. We're gonna run down here and search for our friend Mr. Rhodes. Let's see. Oh yeah, here we go. Gotta get to the relay terminal. I think there's a crate down below that we should go grab first. Yeah, I think we're gonna go down this little on this little platform. Run down here, open the backpack, see what we get. Anything good? No, not really. So back up we go. And let's see, yep, gonna activate this relay. Awesome. Let's keep moving.
Whoever just turned on the lights, you're either JTF,
you're open up the door. And yeah, we're talking to Mr. Rhodes. Here we go. We got some bad guys to contend with.
When you see the dead bodies, get your masks on quick.
Get through that zone, and here we go. Got some more cleaners. Here we go. Now there's guys up high and there's guys down low, so you just gotta be careful when you come in here. They're targeting me right now. Get out of the way. Swap my weapon out. Let's see. There we go. We see a guy up there on the catwalk. See another guy coming around on the side here. We gotta take him down. Guy on the catwalk jumped down. We still got another guy up there on the catwalk. We'll try and take him down here. He's got some grenades, so. Oh, hey. There we go. Get rid of him. We don't need any more flames on us, so. Alright, we're gonna wait for this guy to pop his head out, and then we're gonna take him down a couple bullets at a time. Here we go. Work it, work it. So now we can come in here. Follow the little orange markers, show us where we're going. Peek around, see if there's any loot to grab. I think there's a restock crate back there, but first things first, we're gonna activate that relay. Get things up and going, hit that checkpoint. Yeah, I think there's a restock right there, yeah. So we're gonna grab that. Make sure we got plenty of ammo and get back to it. Here we go. Run down here, around the corner. I mean, this place is one huge maze. I wouldn't want to be lost down here. But at least you get your little mini map to tell you where to go. You know, some of these encounters that you run into, they're really not that bad. There's only two or three guys spread out, but you know, you just never know until you get into it. So these berserkers with their riot shields are a pain in the ass. You really gotta, they don't fire on you, so you don't necessarily hear where they're coming from, or you don't necessarily hear them coming at all. So you just gotta, you know, be on the lookout for them. Yeah, this guy down there, I think that might be the last guy. Yeah, we'll stitch him up a little. I think he's gonna come and try and chase us down. We're gonna try and take him up from up here. And no, I'm gonna have to go down the stairs. Yeah, he's coming up to try and get us. We'll just take him down. There we go. So the next part's a little interesting because you got to pick up these big old circuit breakers and put them back where they belong in the substations. So, being the geek that I am, I actually know quite a bit about circuit breakers, and made me laugh because it's really not that easy to put a circuit breaker into a substation. There's a lot more to it than that, but that's a story for another day. So now you get these guys coming down. You know, they're creeping up on me and I'm trying to take them out, but yeah, there's a guy with an axe. It's no fun. So I'm gonna try and take him down, get my health back up. I think there's another guy on the other side of me. I'm gonna blow the gas can up for good measure. And there, take down this guy. Oh, popped his tank. Watch him explode. I think I die here because I get a little too aggressive. So we'll try and take this guy down. Yeah, they're tuning me up. Yep. Forgot about him. Axe to the face. So we'll reload and hopefully take it to him. So like I said in my last video, I'm not editing out my deaths. I want you to see what happens if you're not paying attention and if you play sloppy. I try not to play sloppy, but you know, it's challenging playing solo, and I like it. It's good fun. I do enjoy more playing with a group of my friends, but I wanted to show you what you can expect if you were to play these story missions solo. You know, and I wanted to show you, you know, the pitfalls and what can happen to you if you do, if you aren't paying attention and you aren't watching what you're doing. So we're taking these guys down. Getting rushed by another berserker, and I'm not doing a good job of checking my surroundings, but I think we've pretty much taken down all the bad guys, and we don't have to worry too much about being flanked at this point. I think we got them all. Looking around, yeah, I think we're good. So we'll just run down here, grab whatever drops they drop for us, which wasn't a whole lot. Carbine, sure, we'll take it. And I think we got another circuit breaker that we need to reinstall into another substation. And let's see, yeah, we gotta get through some baddies first. So there's a bunch of bad guys that kind of work their way through here. You're in the contaminated zone, so you do have to be a little careful, so I'm gonna try and wait and pick off a couple of these guys, but that was kind of a poor use of that smart bomb. Oh, we got a tank, pretty awesome. Like I said in my last video, you know, with a smart bomb, I try and use it more like a booby trap and wait for a couple guys to get into the explosion radius before I detonate it, but it just doesn't seem to work very well for me that way. So I don't really use it a whole lot. I was trying to experiment with it more through these playthroughs because I was hoping it was going to be a little easier to you know, protect myself with and really you know, knock down the health of these incoming waves more than you know, with just some gunfire. So by the time they actually get close to me, that I could just take them down with a few bursts, but it didn't really work out that way. So I'm not too bummed about it. I didn't really die a lot through these. Well, in the security one, I did, but you should go watch that because it's almost comical. So we got some purple guys. They're grenading me, so we're gonna roll out of that. But we already did a ton of damage to them. The fire does spread. It does go down pretty quick, but you can catch on fire pretty easy. So I'm gonna try and come down here and, you know, shoot them through the chain link fence. That worked out pretty well. Get into the healing zone. Then we got this guy. Take him down real quick. And now before our knee caught on fire. Ooh, they got a guy up top. Try and tune him up. A couple more guys down below. So we'll take him down first, and then we'll see if we can get this guy out of here. swap out our weapons. We're not doing a very good job keeping everything fully loaded like I like to normally do. Here we go, we'll swap that out. Oh, forgot there's another wave of these bozos coming in. So there we go, took them down. Long shot with the sticky bomb. So I know there's a crater backpack or something up here, so we'll run over there and grab that real quick, and then we'll get back to that main mission. There are some, you know, on these big maps, there are some little nooks and crannies that, you know, if you don't go exploring, you might never find. And as you can see, we picked up a nice blue 1911 for our sidearm. Yeah, and that thing's pretty nice. So we'll swap out to that. We'll check our inventory because we had been picking up quite a few items there. So, but we're going to head back down and continue on with our mission, try and find Paul Rhodes and get him back to our base of operations. So I think we run through here, and then I want to say there's another circuit breaker that we have to move a lot farther than we did the last one. So we're going to pick that up and move it a little bit before we get some baddies. So when you're carrying this thing, you can attack, but only with your sidearm. And when you're fighting these guys with assault rifles and flamethrowers, it's not really easy to do. So I tend to drop the circuit breaker. Whoa, we're getting torched. They don't move, the bad guys don't move it away from you or anything, so and they can't blow it up as far as I know, so it's fine to just drop it. You're just gonna find it again once you get rid of these guys. So one of these flamethrower guys, he ran up on me pretty quick, but thankfully my assault rifle took him down pretty fast. And then we got another tank pop and kaboom. Nice. It's a lot more rewarding when they take out, you know, some of their own guys when they do that. But I'll take the explosion every time. It's very amusing. It hasn't got old yet. So we're gonna keep walking with this thing. I think we have to go up the stairs. Yeah, we got some more friends coming down to play. So I'm gonna hang out, wait for them to get close, and then I'm gonna pop that, and we torch the first guy, and we shoot the second guy. So I think that's it. So we can go up the stairs unimpeded, get this thing into its respective substation, and continue on. And we're close to the end of this mission. And so far, I think that they're all relatively similar in length. I think the medical wing is probably the quickest. I want to say you can probably rip through that thing in about 15 minutes. And the security and the tech, I want to say, are closer to the 25 to 30 minute mark. You can get through there faster if you really want to, but I like to take my time, you know, play conservative. So we're in the last area of the map. I've played this a number of times, so I know where all the baddies come out, and I know approximately how many waves there are. So they're gonna start coming through this door that I'm sort of looking at, and I'm getting ready to pop the sticky bomb there and try and take out a bunch of them right out of the gate. And the last boss on this level is pretty tough. You know, he's got a flamethrower. It's got a long reach. So there's a lot of movement involved in this end stage, because he's pretty mobile. In the med wing and the security wing missions, the bosses at the end were a little more static. They didn't do a whole lot of moving, and I could pretty much hang back and pick away at them from afar. This is a little more challenging. You got to move around a bit more. You know, because the enemies come from different angles, and they have a lot more range than some of the other ones. So, took out that first wave. I know there's another wave coming from kind of across the map. I think it's that door over there. Or, yeah, there it is. It's up there. So, if I had stayed where I was, they would have come out and just shot on my back. So, you got to keep moving on this one because they come pretty much from every corner of the map each wave. So, I'm going to try and use the, you know, the stuff in the map to my advantage. There's a lot of gas cans, a lot of fuel tanks, if you will, to take advantage of. So, this guy across the way, he's keyed up on me pretty good, but we're going to take him down rather quickly. So, and the best thing to do, you know, especially if you're running solo missions, is to use that, you know, the health. And then I like, once you unlock the security wing, I prefer to get the turret as quickly as I can. That's probably one of my favorite perks, is to use that. So we got a purple guy here. You know, you're gonna have to start moving around because yeah, they're keying up on me pretty good. But definitely, if you're playing solo, have at least the heal ability going, because you can run out of med packs pretty easily on some of these missions. So we're gonna keep moving. Gonna try and reload. Gotta get to some cover first. So here we go. Oh man, he came right up on us. So I think, is there one more baddie up here? Yeah, there's one more baddie up here. So here he is. There we go. Stitched him right up. Okay. So where are they coming from this time? Cross the map up top, I do believe, to the left hand side. Oh no, this is the last batch. Yeah, I think this is the last batch. We can come down the elevator. So this has the head guy on board. Yeah, there he is. You can see he's yellow and he's got a name. So we'll take down all of his little cronies first, or at least try to. We've got a couple of them down already. Now we just gotta get this guy out of the way. Now he's heading this way. So, oh god, I shot the health down there like a dummy. So you should see pretty soon how much reach this guy's flamethrower has. He's way down there and it's reaching right up to the top, so you really do have to be careful. And then this guy's stitching me up from behind, so I gotta get over here, put some distance between me and them, and then try and take out this other guy before Mr. Flamethrower comes to visit. There we go, he's almost down. There we go, finally. Okay, now we can focus on the flamer, if you will. And you know, you just gotta be careful. He's got a lot of reach with that flamethrower. He is fairly slow, so you should be able to move around plenty and keep, this map is big enough that you can keep a lot of space between you and he. So I think if you just keep moving, keep your wits about you, you shouldn't have a problem. The first time I played this, I got absolutely lit up because I really underestimated the reach that flamethrower has, and he toasted me a few times. So you got to stay out of that, because once you're on fire, it takes a while to put it out, and your health just keeps going down and down and down. So try and keep him as far across the map as possible. Yeah, he hit, I think he hit the gas can that I was standing next to, and that did a lot of damage. So keep moving, get him to use that spray, because I think he can only use it in bursts. So there we go, that was a pretty decent hit on him. So the sticky bomb's good for that. And you can pop his tanks. I think I just hit one of them. Yeah, and it did a bunch of damage. All right, so I think his armor's pretty much gone. I mean, he's got a little bit left. So, and as soon as that goes, you know, as soon as you go through, you get through his armor, their armor rather, you know, then it doesn't take much after that. So if, don't get frustrated, just keep picking away. I think I hit his tank again. Yep, there it goes. And then he goes down. It's pretty easy once his armor was gone. He had almost a full health bar, and you know, he went to almost nothing. So he had three green drops for us. We're gonna go over here, we're gonna go in the elevator, head back up, bring Paul Rhodes back to the base of operations, unlock the tech wing, and then we will have all three wings of our base of operation unlocked. And then we can upgrade them through running other missions, doing side missions, earning security wing points or tech wing points, and upgrading those and unlocking the new abilities in each one. So I'm gonna head up through the elevator and head back to base. Gonna try and, I think, just fast travel there. It's a lot easier for some of these missions where you're further away. The fast travel is really nice. It's really handy. So I think there is a backpack over here that's got something in it. Yeah, there it is. So we'll just grab that first. Like I said, these things are scattered all over the place. Most of them have med kits or tear gas grenades or grenades of some sort. So yeah, so the base of operations, we're just fast travel there, and unlock this wing, get this done. And then once you do those three main missions, then you're pretty much on your own. You're on your own anyway, but you know, those are the three main story missions, and then each wing has its own story progression. But they don't really force you one way or the other. It's really all up to you. You know, you can spend tons of time just running around doing all the side missions and collecting the intel, you know, the cell phones and the laptops and everything else. And, you know, you can ignore the main story missions for a while if you so choose. That's one of the nice things about this game. It doesn't really just force you into doing anything. So once you do unlock the wings, though, it's nice to go out and run one of the main missions right away, because you do get a ton of points for whichever wing that mission is for. And you can unlock a lot of the 200 point tier unlocks, or unlock a 400 point tier. I try and mix it up between the different wings. So it, you know, if I'm doing a security wing, I got the med and the security. Now we're gonna open up the tech. You know, if I open up the, I think it's like the ICU and the medical wing, I think it's 400 or 600. Then I will try and open up a bunch of the 200 point unlocks for the tech or the security wing, try and balance it out that way. Just because you do get more talent unlocks and perk unlocks, you know, if you use your points for the smaller ones than you do for the large. So I try and balance it out that way a little bit, you know, just to try and keep my options varied. I like to be able to change up my play style and on the fly. So if you do limit yourself by unlocking those bigger tier upgrades first, you don't have as many abilities and perks at your disposal than if you mix it up, or if you do a lot of the lower tier ones first. So I mean, you play however you want to play. That's just how I like to play. Everyone's got a little bit of different game style, gameplay. That's one of the nice things about going online and playing with some other people, that you can get some ideas and tips and tricks, and you can share some of your tips and tricks with other people. You know, some of the guys that I play with, we complement each other quite nicely. You know, there's one guy that we play with quite a bit, and he tends to go running off like a crazy man, and the other three of us are taking our time, and he invariably gets killed and has to wait for us to come revive him. But the longer we've played, the better we play together. We kind of pull him back a little bit. And I tend to, when I play in a big group, I tend to use a long range sniper rifle and stuff, and he tends to, you know, be up in people's faces with SMG. So I try and protect him, from afar. And the other two guys that we typically play with, you know, they play sort of a mid range to close range players. So it works out well. So we unlock the control room now. We have a few more points to unlock something else. And once we do that, we'll be off and running, and we'll have all three wings open, and we can upgrade them and go do our side missions and see what's what. So I'm not sure if I'm going to do any more in-depths on the Division. I just wanted to do these first three main missions, sort of give you an idea of what to expect if you are interested in playing the game, or if you're not sure what the game is about and you want to get more of an overview than you get from some other channels and some other videos. Like I said, I know these are kind of long videos, but I did want to show you pretty much soup to nuts what you can expect, and not just give you a quick run through and edit out all the death and all the deaths and the interim, all the running around stuff. I don't want to give you a false sense of, oh wow, you can do these missions in 5 minutes. No, it's not going to happen. So hopefully you enjoyed these videos and you like them and you share them with your buddies. Maybe you subscribe. I would greatly appreciate that. And I'm not sure what we're going to do next. We might go back to Far Cry Primal for a bit. We got some new games coming out in another month or so. May's gonna be busy because we have Doom, Battleborn, and Overwatch. So thank you for watching, and like I said, hopefully you like it enough to share it with your friends and subscribe. Until the next time, thanks so much.